The title of the presentation is A Clean and Efficient Implementation of Choreography Synthesis for Behavioral Contracts. I am Davide Basile. This is a joint work with Maurice Terbeck. We are from ISTCNR Pisa. In this paper, we discuss about recent improvements in the contract automata library that has been redesigned using principles of model-based software engineering. In particular, we have performed a reverse engineering on the source code to automatically derive UML diagrams. We have completely refactored the source code in Java 8 that contains lambda expressions and parallel streams. In this way, we have a more cleaner and efficient code, that is, with fewer lines of code and improved performances. We discussed the implementation of the abstract synthesis algorithm first introduced in our coordination's 2019 paper. And we discussed the adherence of the specification with the implementation and experiments to show the improvements. The background is behavioral contracts that are used to specify the interfaces of services in order to compute a contract-based coordination policy of an orchestration of services. For example, orchestrations or choreographies as coordination policies, or even the most permissive controller from supervisory control theory. Contract automata are finite state automata whose labels are service actions that are partitioned into offers or requests that have to be matched, each offer with a request, to achieve an agreement among a composition of contracts. Actions have modalities. They can be necessary or permitted. Necessary action must be matched in the composition, while permitted action can be withdrawn. And which action can be necessary between offers or requests, and which has to be matched, depends on the specific coordination policy, as we will see. This is, in a nutshell, an example of the formalism. This is actually an example from the fourth presentation of this year. We have two kids, Alice and Bob, that are on the top part, and this is the composition and this is the synthesized orchestration. Basically, here we have Alice, which performs a necessary ananas request and offers a cherry, and you can see that there are different points. This is the contract of Bob. Here we want to enforce agreement, that is, we want all requests to be matched and the necessary requests have to be matched. In particular, in the composition, we have this request of Bob that is not matched by a corresponding offer. So this request, let's say, is bad, and the orchestration wants to prune the transition and also this state, because it's dangling. From this state, it's not possible to reach an accepting state where both contracts are satisfied. So also this transition has to be pruned. Now, this is a necessary request. We see that the necessary request, Ananas of Alice, is also matched in state 0-1 in the orchestration, where Alice is still in state 0, she performs the ananas request that is matched. So in this case, in the orchestration, the synthesis of the orchestration can prune this necessary request. This is because we consider this necessary notion of a request as a lazy transition, as we will describe later on. If this would be a standard notion of uncontrollable transition from supervisory control theory, then we would not be able to prune this transition. And we call uncontrollable transitions as urgent necessary actions in our formalism. So in the implementation, we have two packages, two different repositories to enforce separation of concerns between the API, the library of the tool, and the graphical representation. Indeed, in this talk, we are not concerned with the usability of the graphical interface, but in the quality of the implementation, in terms of lines of code, performance, and so on, in order to be reusable by other researchers in coordination. In particular, the contract automata lib repository has two packages, contract automata, which is the main package that we will discuss, and family, which is a package containing configurable contracts that will be discussed in the fourth, talk this year. Then we have the package for the graphical application. We just saw a snapshot of the graphical application. And this is actually an example of using the library as a backend for the graphical application. The GUI has been implemented using this open source library. This is the class diagram of the package contract automata that has been automatically generated with Sparks Enterprise Architect extracting from the source code. The main class is MSCA, Model Service Contract Automata, which contains the methods for computing the composition and the various coordinations. We can also say here that states of contract automata are vectors of basic states, that the labels are partitioned into request of error match, and the transitions have modalities. They can be either permitted urgent or lazy, as I've just described. This is the abstract synthesis algorithm that was firstly presented in the Coordination 2019, and we also have a journal version and logical methods in computer science. This is the standard, we basically generalize the standard algorithm for synthesizing the most permissive controller for supervisory control theory, which is a fixed point computation where at each step we refine the transitions of the automaton and we increase the number of forbidden states that we encounter during the synthesis. In particular, here we have a forbidden predicate to decide when a transition has to be pruned, a pruning predicate, sorry, to decide when a transition has to be pruned, and a forbidden predicate to decide when a state is forbidden or not. This is the implementation of the abstract synthesis in our tool. We see that, for example, the pruning and forbidden predicates are rendered as three predicates, which takes three arguments. We can also say that the fixed point computation is rendered as a do-while loop. And for deciding which transition has to be pruned and which state is forbidden, we compute this set using parallel streams to speed up the computations in Java. Other than that, it is a pretty straightforward implementation of the specification. And in the paper, you will find an informal argument of the adherence of this implementation with the specification. We can move on and discuss then the implementation of the most permissive controller and the orchestration synthesis. Basically, these methods simply use the abstract synthesis algorithm, in this case the method, bypassing the pruning predicate and forbidden predicate. In this case, we want to enforce the property of agreement in both cases. So a transition is pruned if its state is target state of the transition is bad or the transition is a request. As we have seen in the example, in this case, for example, the chair request will be pruned by the algorithm. And there is a difference in when a state is deemed forbidden. As I have just explained in the example previously, for what concerns the notion of most permissive controller, we have that a transition, if a removed transition that is not contained anymore in the automaton, is urgent, then this means that the source state of this transition becomes forbidden. We see that source state of transitions that satisfy the forbidden predicate as selected in this instruction here, get source. So for example, if we would have that this transition is urgent instead of lazy, the synthesis firstly removes the request transition because it satisfies the pruning predicate. Then the state becomes dangling. It is not possible to reach the final state and it becomes bad. Since this state is bad, this transition has a target state which is bad or forbidden, this transition is removed. At this point, if this transition would be urgent, this means that also the initial state would be bad. Indeed, there is no most permissive controller in this example. On the other hand, with the orchestration, we have an existential notion that is basically, we call them lazy transition. In this case, this transition is removed and the state is not bad because this transition is not considered uncontrollable because the same principle Alice, there exists another transition in which the principle performing the request, in this case Alice, is still in the same state performing the same request that is matched. So in this case the request is satisfied and everything is okay. So basically for the synthesis of the controller, we have a universally quantified notion of necessary transition, in this case urgent, while for the orchestration we have an existential quantification in our lazy necessary matches. The reason is that the controller is dealing with an unpredictable environment, so the controller cannot really control the actions coming from the environment that are uncontrollable, while in the orchestration we have a different situation because the necessary requests have to be matched, but the orchestrator can drive the contracts towards a behavior in agreement. In this case, the orchestrator can drive the contract to match its necessary request in a particular configuration. And it is not necessary that this request must be matched in every possible configuration. So now we come to the synthesis of the choreography. This is again the specification in the journal version of Coordination 2019. There are three main differences. In the choreography, there is a different notion of agreement called strong agreement. So we consider as we prune also offers a transition and not only request. So in a coordination, all in a choreography, all transitions have to be synchronization, or as we call matches. Then we have also a different notion of uncontrollability. In the orchestration, the lazy transition is existentially quantified over all possible configuration of the composition, whilst in the choreography, the lazy necessary transition is quantified over over only the source state where this transition is fired in the composition. Then a crucial notion is that of branching condition. The main difference between a choreography and an orchestration is that in the choreography, the principles have to be capable of interacting and evolving independently on the state of the other participants in the composition, because there is no orchestration. So we have this property, branching condition. A transition is violating the branching condition if it is violating this property of independency. So in the synthesis, at each iteration, we select also a subset of these transitions violating the branching condition that are removed. Note that the only requirement is that when we reach the fixed point, this set of branching condition of transitions violating the branching condition must be empty. But at how many transitions we remove at each step is not defined in the specification. Indeed, this would all compute different choreographies depending on how we select these transitions violating the branching condition. We implemented this in this way. We have a do-while loop where we iterate, and at each iteration we call the synthesis of the choreography by passing the pruning predicate and the forbidden predicate. In this case, in the forbidden predicate, we had a different notion of uncontrollability for choreography, as we just said, while the pruning predicate is also considering the transition violating the branching condition. At the beginning, this set is empty. At each iteration, we select a transition violating the branching condition, and we add this transition to the set of transition violating the branching condition, and then we iterate. So basically, at each iteration, we remove a greater number of transition violating the branching condition, until there are no more transitions and we return the choreography. This is because we want to remove as few number of transitions violating the branching condition as possible, because when we remove one of these transitions, it could be that another transition violating the predicate of branching condition is automatically amended, and we don't need to remove that transition also. Note that we can have different choreographies depending on how we select the transition that violate the branching condition. In this case, we have a non-deterministic selection with defined any instruction. We have parallel streams, so basically the first thread which finds a transition violating the branching condition returns the transition. So depending on the order, we could have different selection of transitions and we could have different choreographies as output. Coming to the performances and the lines of code, we see that we compare our implementation with the previous implementation, and there is a great increment in the performances, and also there is a great reduction in the lines of code. This is because we try to do the maximal gain with minimum effort. Since this tool has been developed over the years, we had that developed using incremental patches over the years to do the minimum effort to obtain a result. But in this way, the code was increasingly becoming unmanageable and the performance were deteriorating. So we decided to completely refactor and rewrite the implementation to obtain the results that you see in this slide. We come to the conclusion. We have presented recent enhancement in the contract automaton implementation tool for what concerns the design of the tool. The its code, we have a clean code, and the performances. We have also compared the different synthesis algorithms, for example, the most permissive controller, the orchestration and the choreography. And we hope that other researchers in the coordination and supervisory control area will have a look at our tool that is open source and freely available here. In particular, we hope that the implementation could be used as a back-end of tools which uses more complex formalisms for expressing services, whose semantics, however, could be expressed in terms of contract automata. As future work, we have for now an informal argument on the correctness of the implementation with respect to the specification. It would be interesting to investigate formal proofs using the Ethereum Prover Key and Java modeling language as a specification language. However, as for now, there is not yet the support of Java 8, so this is more of a long-term goal. The synthesis that we have presented is subtractive. We prune transitions. There are also papers about additive synthesis by adding other transitions, and we are currently investigating these synthesis algorithms. And as future, we would like to refactor the family package, implement the specification of timed service contract automata that we have, whose theory we already developed, and perform a further study other applications of our tool. Thanks for your attention.